Hi, I'm Veronica Wasek with 5-Minute Bookkeeping, and I help Shopify sellers to set up, organize, and streamline their financial systems, whether you're looking for DIY, done with you, or done for you financials. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick tour of a brand new inventory report in Shopify. I'm so excited to share with you the new month-end inventory report that Shopify just released. If you watch my previous videos, you know that I said that you couldn't get a report out of Shopify that would give you the inventory quantity and cost that we need to update the books on QuickBooks Online and to update them for the inventory balance. But actually now with this new month-end inventory report, we can get the number that we need to make that adjustment. So let's go ahead and take a look at how you can run the new Shopify month-end inventory report. From Shopify, click Analytics and Reports. Scroll down till you see the inventory reports. Click Show All. Select Month-End Inventory Value Report. And here's the magical number that I have been waiting for. This is the total inventory value. And it is comprised of all of the inventory items, taking the cost of those inventory items times the ending quantities for those items and giving us a total dollar amount for inventory value. The report will default to the prior month end, but you can change the date and select the desired date and run the report for any other time frame that you want to run it for. One thing to note is that you do need to review the cost and quantities for each of your SKUs. Verify that they're correct. There should be no negative quantities or negative amounts. And as we can see here, we have a couple of issues that we need to deal with because, as I said, we shouldn't have any negative amounts. If you do have negative amounts, then the inventory amount is not going to be correct. Let's take a look and see then how we fix the product costs and quantities. So go to Products and Inventory. Review the list of products and edit quantities. You should do this on a regular basis. As you can see here, we have an available quantity of negative 16. You can just edit that quantity here and save when you're done. To edit the product cost, click on the product and then edit the cost per item. So you'll do that here, edit that cost per item. Make sure that track quantity is checked so that Shopify will track the quantity for your product. So there you go, it's that simple. That's how you run the month-end inventory report from Shopify. So can I give a big thumbs up to the Shopify developers for giving us accountants this report that we have been waiting for so long to have. So why am I so excited about this new report? Well, it's because we can now use that inventory amount to adjust the inventory balance in QuickBooks. Now, I have a separate video in which I show you how to do that using a journal entry, so I'll go ahead and link that video in the description box below for you so you can learn how to adjust the inventory balance in QuickBooks using a journal entry. I'm Veronica Wasek with 5-Minute Bookkeeping. If this content is helping you, make sure that you subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up. If you're ready to work with a trusted and reliable Shopify accounting pro, then check the description box below to learn more about my services and how we might work together. And check the description box below for all of my free resources, including my free Shopify bookkeeping blueprint and the link to join my Facebook community. And let me know in the comments if there's any other topics that you want me to do for you in the future. I'm here to help you. I'm Veronica Wasek with 5-Minute Bookkeeping. I'll see you next time.